Hi guys and welcome back to the channel. Long time ago I have built a simple LED to being used when I record my videos and as well when I work on my electronics projects. The light performed well, but now after nearly 1 year and few changes, I decide it's time to make few more of them. So I decide to make a smaller version of it. Now for the LED, the original one was 20 watts each, but I have changed to around 50 watts each. I want to make the LED panel smallest as possible and as well to be able to output some decent light, so I choose to go with these two 10 watts cold and warm LED which I was having lying around. After I decide which type of LED I will be using, I have to test them to see if they will work. So let's connect them to my variable power supply and increase the output voltage, and as you can see the LED perform well. The current which the LED is required is around 300 mAh. Here is the cold one. And as well here is the warm one. Now the LED can run without a heatsink, and for that I will be using this aluminium sheet which I was having lying around. And after I cut it with the help of my saw, I got a smaller piece which will serve as our heatsink. Now after I start marking the LED holes with a marker and drill all the holes using a 5mm drill bit. After all the holes are done, I have used some sandpaper to smooth out the surface of the aluminium sheet. Now after all of this, we got a nice sheet for our LED to act as a heatsink. After adding a bit of thermal paste, we can secure the LED using M3 screws in combination with washers and nuts. After the two LED are mounted on the heatsink, we can test the LED, and as you can see they work fine. Now let's start making a small board which will be containing a simple latching switch and two PWM driver or pulse width modulation. All three circuits, they are based on 5x5 timer. Now the schematic is in front of you. I will be not explaining the working principle of the circuit operation because I have made the video for the two circuits in more detail. Link to them can be found in the video description. Now let's grab all the components for our control board, and as well I will be soldering everything on a small prototyping board which is often called Vero board. Starting first with the latching circuit. After the circuit is done, we can test it, and as you can see, it's working like it should. Now I have started working on the two PWM driver. Which they will be using for adjusting the light of the LED independently. After the circuit is done, we can use the light like this, but it's not practical. So I decide to use this box which is designed to be used for outlets. For cooling the LED, I decide to go with this 60mm fan, and the fan will be powered from 12 volts as with the LED. After cutting the hole in the box using a hole saw with a diameter of around 54mm, I continue it by drilling the two holes for securing the fan to the box. And as well, I will be adding a 60mm grill to the back of the fan. This is mainly for preventing the finger from being chopped when I will be grabbing the LED when they are on. Now for securing the two potentiometers and as well the momentary switch and the DC jack, I will be using a small piece of aluminium which I have cut it as well with the saw beforehand. After I start marking using a marker the spot where the holes will be drilled for accommodating the parts. First I start drilling the holes for the potentiometers using a 5mm drill bit. For the DC jack as well, I have used first the 5mm drill bit, and after I proceed further with the stepping bit which is more suitable for this kind of application. After all the mandatory holes are drilled, I have used some sandpaper for smoothing out the edges and as well to give a bit of texture to the metal part. Now after securing the aluminium part to the outlet box, I have cut a second piece which is in an L shape to go in the back. This is only for aesthetic purposes. Before securing the PCB inside the box, I have used some black small standoffs to secure the PCB and as well all the parts of the metal bracket. The only thing remaining to do is to secure the heatsink to the box. After doing so, the LED light can be used simply by just connecting it up to a 12 volts supply or a battery, and after pressing the momentary switch, we can control the two LED independently. I decide to not make a reflector for the LED, due to the reason the dye of the LED provide an even illumination. Still, for better aesthetics, I decide to use a small piece which I have cut out of a plexiglass sheet which I have from an old LCD monitor, and after cutting it up using a Dremel, which by the way, a link to it can be found in the video description if you are interested in how to make one. I followed that up with a file and after with some sandpaper to give it a foggy texture. This is important because it will help spreading the light more evenly and as well for protecting the LED. For attaching the plexiglass to the box, I will be using some small L-shaped bracket and some 3mm computer standoffs. After securing the plexiglass to the box, the light is done and as well as you can see it's performed very well. So I decided to make a second one. So this was a fun project to make and as well I hope you have learned something interesting today. I hope I will see you all in my next video. Until then, have a nice day and thank you very much for watching. See ya!